Yes, there's another episode of Clinton Something next here on the show.
Clinton Something, the campaign years.
You know, hon, I hate to be putting a speed bump in this process, but, well, you know, I just can't stop thinking about tomorrow.
Bill, you're making me sorry I ever chose that as your theme song.
I always hated it. But I just think we could cut through this process a lot faster if we edited the transcript instead.
Look, the words on paper can't convey some of the playfulness of my delivery. On paper, it sounds a lot worse than it does when you watch the tape, that's all.
I know, but the primary is Tuesday, and there's, what, 6 speeches to watch and edit? That's an awful lot of diet pizzas we're going to have to order in.
There's got to be other stuff we can order. We're in Manhattan, for God's sake.
Hun, we're in Harlem. You know, your home.
Look, the longer we argue about this, the longer it's going to take. Let's just strap it on and get moving.
Well, when you put it that way.
Good evening. I'm so happy to be with you, wonderful folks, here tonight. For so many of us in New York, the name Goldman Sachs is the gold standard of financial acumen. My favorite kind of men, by the way.
We can lose that, right?
Gold standard?
Bad joke.
Okay. I blame Huma.
I know. That's what she's there for.
Cool. Let's lose it and move on.
Yes, ma'am.
We all know that the financial industry is getting something of a battering from the media these days. I'm a bit of an expert on the subject of media batterings. And based on my experience, my advice to you folks would be to hire James Carville and let him, as he once put it, open a can of whoop-ass on Paula Jones.
What?
Kind of obvious, what?
Bill, it's a joke.
It's old news. And when it was news, it wasn't really news.
This is a biggie for you.
Just think you want to seem more, you know, relevant.
I thought saying whoop-ass accomplished that.
Mm-mm. Made you sound old school.
Oh, nice. Playing the granny card.
I'm not...
Fine. It's out. Onward.
But seriously, I have to disagree with your chairman, Lloyd Blankfein, who recently said he thought Goldman Sachs was doing God's work.
This we can use.
The way I see it, God is doing Goldman Sachs's work.
Or not.
You know something?
What?
I think this would work better as a transcript. I mean, these laughs are kind of weak, don't you think?
They're finance guys. They only laugh at numbers.
Okay. Keep going.
Yes, it gets better.
Reason to live.
As some of you know, I guess all of you know, I'm in the president's cabinet. I see Eric Holder on a weekly basis. To be fair, we don't talk about the Justice Department's case against your company. But I do think I can tell you folks one thing. The slap marks on your wrist should heal very soon.
Well, so far we've got good evening. Not really that much of a transcript.
Not helping.
You know, we could just release the transcript of your domino game in East Harlem instead. Much less redacting to do.
Really not helping. Look, let's just cut out all the humorous parts and go straight to the policy stuff.
Less embarrassing?
More opaque.
Okay.
But you know what? I've got New York in the bag. Let's reset the deadline for all this. Give ourselves some time.
California primary's not till June.
We can make June.
Easy. Tell you what?
Yeah.
I'm going to go cancel the diet pizza.
Youthful angst and middle-aged need to serve. Together they add up to Clintonsomething, the campaign years.